because he's firstly using my name.
Yes.
If a far-right youngster who watches this, he can say, this guy is grooming this guy,
yes,
and he can come for my life.
Yes.
Just the way Tommy is afraid for his life, I am. Yeah? And I have had their friends from the far-right, yeah, who've had police give us Osman warning. Yes, sir. They went to the phone box. We've got that, yeah? We've got audio recordings, yeah? And anyway, that's a different story. The point here is this, yeah? This man is not mentally well. He's clearly saying he wants to kill white guys, yes. white men.
Yes.
Why is he not locked up, let alone be in a mental institute?
Because he's Muslim.
No. Yeah. It's wrong then. Yeah. It's wrong.
If Tommy Robinson were if I or him went onto a live stream and said, we're going to murder any Muslim, we'd be off
the same should be done to him.
But it's not.
So now the thing is, Abdul is. Tommy Robinson was after him for the right reasons.
He weren't going to hit him.
No, I know.
He wanted him arrested.
So, now, if I am after a white far-right, let's say someone who's mentally not well,
yeah?
If I chase him down the road, and he knows my situation with Tommy Robinson, and he falls down at the middle of the night, who do you think he will mention? Tommy Robinson. Tommy Robinson made me do it. Why? Because he knows I have a problem with him.
No, but that's a direct link. You're saying a direct link. Abdul, no different. Let me finish.
What?
Yeah,
what?
The link that's been happening is Abdul said your name. Yeah?
No,
that's that a difference.
Was when Tommy, that's
have
when,
you ever been arrested for this? Have you been pulled in by the police for the last three or four days when he made that accusation with your name?
No, one second.
Why not?
One second.
Why
have you been pulled in? Firstly, I watched that video of his. In that video, he mentions my name.
That's good enough.
He doesn't. Okay. You want to go there? Okay, no problem. So if you're saying that, if I say I am going to kill 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I go and say I like chocolate fudge cake as well, and Tommy Danny, what's his name?
What's wrong with chocolate?
Yeah, no, one second, no.
I'm going to say
wrong with it. One second. So now I'm going to say, hold on a second. He threatened everybody. Then he said he likes chocolate fudge cake, and he mentioned his name.
Okay, did Abdul mention chocolate cake? Did he mention chocolate cake?
He mentioned a variety, he started rapping. Well, yeah, he started rapping in there. Well, I watched the video.
He didn't go off at a tantrum.
I got the video. He starts rapping. And then he starts talking about his biceps or weird stuff. Now, what is more legitimate is the following. This you cannot use it. It was a nice try. However, Darren Osborne, yeah?
Yes.
You can't come and say mentally unwell because the guy, they looked on his iPad. He was watching Tommy Robinson's stuff. Now, Tommy Robinson, have you ever come and made me... Have you ever seen
a video of me...
Let me finish. Have you ever seen a video of me saying, behind me these kuffar, enemy combatants who want to maim, rape,
no,
and kill
no,
me.
No. Hold on, wait.
One second, I'm going to finish.
No, before you
finish, be patient, I'll listen to you.
That was said about ISIS fighters that have come back. Come back to Manchester, and there were 150 ISIS fighters within that community. He was saying they are here as enemy combatants.
Okay.
He wasn't talking about Muslims, he was talking about the ISIS fighters.
Thanks for the context.
Okay.
However, Darren Osborne, they checked this iPad. He was watching Britain First and Tommy Robinson, yeah? Now, in his letter in his car...
What, just that?
No, just that. And he was watching Cartoon Network as well, yeah?
Probably.
Okay. okay. And then in his letter at the end, he used a tweet from Tommy Robinson.
Never support Tommy.
One second. Let me finish, yeah? Darren Osborne, yeah? Okay. Now, this guy is not mentally unwell. He travelled all the way from Wales, yeah, to run innocent people off.
Yeah, but you
now,
know what?
Guys, one person, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
All right,
allow me to talk, yeah? The point here is this. Christchurch. Tommy came here and read whose statement? Danny Stelner?
Listen.
Let me finish.
He also said Nelson Mandela was his inspiration.
Let me finish.
Danny,
we're having a nice, fruitful discussion.
Yeah, because you're trying to make
so this argument of Abdul, you guys know very well, deep inside your heart.
What are you using your name?
What's he using your name?
Listen. You're the only name he used.
If they used Tommy Robinson and tried to say that he... No. If Darren Osborne was walking to the court and he said, Tommy Robinson, and they said, Tommy is the cause, I'll say this is nonsense. It's not fair.
Can I just say something? Stop there.
You stop me. I'm being stopped. You're like traffic wardens. I'm being stopped every 2 seconds.
Alec, please. In the MSN, right, it did say Tommy Robinson with Darren Osborne. Proven wrong.
No.
But why isn't you in the paper
about... Because it's a false comparison.
No!
Yes, let me explain. Let me explain. A psychologically ill man uses my name. He doesn't say Ali Dawa got me to in that video.
He said Ali Dawa radicalized
me.
In that video.
No, in many videos.
I dare you to open that and find me that statement. I challenge you. You never do it. You know that, Tommy, yeah? I mean, Danny, yeah?
She's got
Now, hear me. No, let me finish, yeah? Now, Tommy Robinson came here and read whose statement? Martin, someone else, whatever his name, Okay, the guy who carried out the Christchurch attack, 50 Muslims, bang, bang, bang. Did you see how he shot that Muslim girl in the head? Boom.
Yeah.
Okay. He was giving money, donating to their cause. I don't know what their cause is yet. Tommy Robinson was seen with that guy. If you want to make any kind of connection, this is a connection that shows Tommy is causing innocent people to die. Because, number one, that guy was not mentally unwell. Darren Osborne wasn't mentally unwell. Joe Cox's killer wasn't mentally unwell. Yeah?
But there's no direct contact.
No direct link to them. I was watching Tommy Robinson's videos. Now, in my videos, have I ever preached hate against anyone?
Let me say why. There's other minorities. There's other minorities in Islam. You hated them. Why are you running, Ali?
Let me tell you why.
There's other people that don't agree with his core of Islam. He attacks them sometimes. I'm just being fair. I told you I love you.
We are doing this because you are non-Muslim. Because the Muhammad told us that you can take slaves. You can take sex slaves. Well, didn't say that in the Quran.
I'm going to use one victim who's a true hero to debunk what you're saying.
Awesome. She doesn't represent the majority of victims that we have been speaking to.
So which one
Rochdale, Rotherham, Telford, Oxford, Bradford, Birmingham, they are all Muslim men. You can't get away from it.
Okay, one second.
Just like the ones on the internet are white men.
One second.
And I'll agree with you. They are white.
Did you hear that?
White Christian.
Now he brought it in, yeah?
Okay.
Now, look at it. You know very well, I have not come across a single victim that has come and said, these men beat me and they will read in the Quran. Show me one. I'm asking for one statement of a girl that's been groomed that said they use Islam. I challenge you.
They use it.
Show me.
The victims themselves tell us. They quote themselves.
They tell you, but they don't tell the media.
The media don't listen to them. The media won't listen. The Rape of Britain documentary coming later this January.
How many girls were
1,500.
How many girls were what? In total?
1,000.
Let's say 10,000. Out of those 10,000, if 200 say...
Robert, please, for the sake of my life.
Robert, are you going to let me talk?
I want to listen.
Okay, can you listen? Now, what I'm saying is this. Let's say 10,000 Jews got groomed. Out of them, let's say 200 said it was because of this person's religion. Majority show that it can't be. So, for example, if 90% of pedophiles are white men, I would be wrong to say
in a certain organization of crime. Not overall.
Okay. So, is it fair for me to say that I have to watch out for white middle-aged men?
You have daughters, kids, 100%. I don't let my kids go onto Xbox because I'm worried about the white men in this country that use the Xbox to contact young children.
You see, I've noticed a few times that you see, but you missed the word Christian.
We have to identify where the problem comes from.
But when it's the Muslim issue, you keep bringing Muslims.
Because they are Muslim.
Okay.
Do we say brown men?
Okay, can we say? Okay.
Well, how would you categorize?
I would categorize them as the following, yeah? I can say Pakistani men, Sri Lankan men, Indian men, in a totality, Asian men, brown men.
When they bring religion into it,
I'm telling you, please. No. You know very well, Sammy Woodhouse is a beautiful example.
A man of principle, because he's
has Imam Tawhidi been with the Muslims from day one? Never. All the Australians reject him. Kanan was with Tommy, and even Kanan, I had a back and forth with him. I was after Kanan before I was after Tommy Robinson. I wanted to meet Kanan first to give Tommy.
Has gone from different group to different group to different group.
No,
all based on money.
No, I'm so sorry. Kanan has been with Tommy Robinson for a couple of years because I wanted to confront him, and I was even looking for him. I was needing to school to catch him. So he's been consistent with Tommy, don't give me that.
So you're saying you've been with someone that's been close to Tommy for many, many years, and the worst thing that you can say is that he said he was happy with a terrorist.
This is profound. The point is this, I spoke to Nick Griffin. Yeah?
And then before said to me, Islam.
No, you're racist. You're racist.
No, no, one second. Okay, I'm saying to you.
You sat down.
No, I was. I didn't get a chance.
Oh, right.
It was when my dad was passed. Right. I didn't get it. The point is, they never said to me that they offered him money. The bankers. They said, we want you to be.
What's that?
And the bankers are the ones.
You're putting your finger over the speaker. No, Zach just said,
sorry,
look.
Mate,
the bankers said, the bankers are the ones who are robbing us, yeah? Who are robbing this country. And these bankers are funding.
Put that on there, Liz.
Sorry?
Do you want me to put that on there?
No, I'm going
to
finish it.
Your bank cards and your phone.
And what do they want? They
your
want.
I've got the bus this morning.
No, what's it?
That's how much I get.
No, what's it? I work at Uber. That's how much I'm being here. Okay, the point is this, yeah? They want us to fight each other, yeah? The guys at the top.
Okay.
This is a war between the rich and the poor. Not the Muslim and the far right and the Christian. It's between the rich and the poor. When I see homeless people there in the streets, and people are talking about niqab, right. The niqab is not causing someone to be homeless. That's a different issue. But the point is, it's there to sabotage, to concentrate on the Muslims. It was the Jews before, and it was the blacks, and then it was the Japanese. Now it's the Muslim. Now we are the target. Now we are the...
So you can't think of any legitimate reason
no.
why the world, I'm not talking about the United Kingdom, I'm talking about the world, has a bit of an issue with Islam.
No, I'll be honest. I'll tell you something.
Let me tell you one.
No.
Let me tell you one.
Because...